Linking processes in Insight can get very complex. Doug Insight's workflow tool automates linking multiple processes together, simplifying the chaining process. We have some pre-NMO gathers, which would benefit for some gather conditioning. Let's create a workflow to apply an NMO correction and run it through a simple denoise workflow. Workflows act like a folder, into which any number of processes can be dragged. The order of the processes defines the order of execution. Workflows manage process outputs by grouping processes and their resulting volumes together in the same order in the Volume tab. We'll see this after building our denoise workflow. Creating a workflow is fairly simple. Click on the blue button and name your workflow. In workflows, the output from one process is automatically the input for the next process. Input volumes are configured directly in the workflow. In more complex workflows, the same Insight product may be used in different processes. Making minor changes to this product requires searching all the processes in a workflow. To simplify this process, a workflow variable can be created. The input value can be set as a variable instead of a specific value. Changing the variable's value then automatically changes the value in all linked inputs. Create new variables in the variable section and link an input by clicking the linking icon next to the selection box. Let's start by applying an NMO correction. Click on the blue button to add a new NMO process. Click Add. We'll keep the Create Process dialog open since we're going to add some more processes to this workflow. Notice the original volume selected as input volume for the workflow has been auto-selected as input. The Volume Details panel is a little hard to QC. Doug Insight's Split Panel option easily splits the control panel, making quickly editing processes easier. Much better. I'll make some configuration changes and QC the on-the-fly result. Switching the volume in the Gather view shows a great result. Our events are much flatter. Process groups are a helpful organizational tool which groups multiple processes together within a flow. Great for arranging long lists of processes. In this example, we'll use it to contain our denoise flow. The next process is a bandpass filter. Our corrected NMO gathers output is auto-selected as input. This process performs a bandpass filtering of a volume using a zero-phase Butterworth filter. In the Gather view, we can review the changes applied by the bandpass filter by switching the displayed volume to Stage 2. Cancel filter shows the bandpass filter input already selected. Doug Insight's interactive processing allows interactive editing of parameters to get the best result possible. Switching to Stage 3 shows slight changes in the data. To view what noise has been removed, we can switch to viewing the noise model instead. As mentioned previously, workflows manage process outputs by grouping processes and their resulting volumes together in the same order in the Volume tab. Either right-click on the process and select Open the Output Volume, or for hotkey lovers, use Ctrl-P. A QC output would be helpful at this point in the workflow. Add a workflow branch by right-clicking on Cancel Filter. This will take a workflow's intermediate state at this point and apply any processes listed in the workflow branch. Processes can be dragged and dropped to a different location within the workflow with ease. Doug Insight will reorder the volumes automatically in the Volume tab. In this case, I'll move the workflow branch to after the Cancel Filter. The remainder of the parent workflow will continue, unaffected by this branch process. Great for some quick QCs throughout the workflow. Adding some angle stacks from the filter data would be useful. Add these to a selection group to easily scroll through each volume in inline crossline view, making QC a lot easier. back to the Kanzhao filter. We're happy with the results. Let's apply it to these shots. Create a total denoise difference volume by subtracting the Kanzhao from the original NMO volume input. Let's quickly compare the input and output volume by viewing in a selection group. Our workflow is completed. It's neatly arranged in the Volume tab. Hotkey Ctrl-P will quickly switch from Process tab to Volume tab. Workflows can be easily shared between sessions and other projects by archiving workflows. Archived workflows only export the metadata of the input parameters for the workflow. This keeps the correct parameters set throughout the workflow after transfer. Workflow inputs can be easily updated for the new project. Doug Insight exports these to Archived Workflows folder, stored in the main project folder. These can be easily imported into any new project via Control Panel, Import, Archived Workflows. That's it. Enjoy using workflows.
If you have questions or would like to discover more, then visit our website at www.doug.com. And remember, have fun with Insight.